So Kevin Smith has taken to the media to beg for a job at Marvel. And when I say beg, I want to make this very clear to everyone out there. Kevin Smith has gone as far as to say that I suck the of Marvel Comics. That's right. He is going far enough to lay down and say, you know what, Kevin Feige, I will do anything for a job at all at Marvel. Please, please hire me. Please hire me indeed. Now, while begging for this job, mind you, he doesn't stop there. Oh no, not by a long shot. He talks about how brilliant these movies are, how he thinks they're all fantastic. They're my favorite form of entertainment, according to him. And then as far as Kevin Feige is concerned, he says that Kevin Feige is his favorite living American filmmaker right now. Yeah, I mean that is an audition and then some. Oh man, so hey there to all you fine folks on this fine day. I hope you are doing excellently. And I want to make something very clear from go. I don't actually care about Marvel movies these days. I think the products are shoddy. I think that Marvel has denigrated their customers time and again, and I don't think that behavior deserves forgiveness. But this here, I find this entertaining. Why? Because Kevin Smith, he would do just about anything for a job at Marvel. Again, his own words, I suck the of Marvel movies. Hilariously enough, though, Kevin Smith, he won't come right out and say this. Oh no, in fact, it's the opposite. He'll say what I quoted to you. He'll say a lot more, mind you. But when it comes to the movies itself, he tries to be coy about it. He tries to pretend if I was offered it, maybe I would give it back. Yeah, this interview, it is absolutely hilarious. I mean, you can hear Kevin Smith in his words, set to the background of Kevin Smith crying over and over and over. Now, all of this and so much more, it comes up in an interview with UpRocks. You can see that at the very top here. A lively chat with Kevin Smith about Marvel, Tusk, and his new book. And the funniest thing about this is I would have missed out totally on it. Like I said, I don't care very much for Kevin Smith. I don't care very much about Marvel products right now. But I kept seeing headlines from places like Comic Book, from places like Screen Rant and on. And I mean, look at these titles here. Kevin Smith reveals the two times Kevin Feige called him directly. Marvel called Kevin Smith twice, but never to direct an MCU movie. Kevin Smith explains why he can't direct a Marvel movie. Again and again, you see this point hammered home. And remember, this is shill media right here. Many of these places, they are friends or friendly with Kevin Smith. Like I said, this isn't an interview. This is somebody trying to get a job. And oh man, looking at that desperation. Mwah. It is golden. Now, if you looked at those snippets that I showed you earlier and you thought, man, that is absolutely freaking pathetic. Well, you know what? You ain't seen nothing yet. I mean, when you look at these words in context, when you see what Kevin Smith is actually trying to do, it's sad. Again, he is begging for a job. I'm sure that he would deny this stuff. He would lie about it, even though it's in black and white. But yeah, I'm going to read you part of this and I'll let you be the judge. So this, it's in the middle of an interview, by the way. UpRocks, they're asking about picking up projects. They mention He-Man and on. And they ask Kevin Smith, creative control is also part of it, right? Not to start a Marvel thing. I don't want to make you the latest director to comment on Marvel, but... Now, you have Kevin Smith interrupt right there. He laughs and says, who was it this morning? And UpRocks, they answer by saying it was the director of Dune, essentially. That's who they're talking about. Kevin Smith, he replies by saying, let me just say unequivocally for the record that I suck the of Marvel movies. I think they're brilliant. I think they're fantastic. They're my favorite form of entertainment. And Kevin Feige is a favorite living American filmmaker right now. I mean, you can see his answer there. You can see they want to play this off as a joke, as it were. But as things move forward, yeah, he's not joking about it at all. Now, the funny thing is that the interviewer, they laugh. They try to give a segue. They try to treat this as a joke. But all of this, it moves back. And look how Kevin Smith treats this. this. So he's asked, checked off all the boxes. Great. No, but I love Marvel movies. They don't check every box for me, but I'm not the target audience necessarily, which I accept completely. But the notion of, it's a big bleeping corporation, you're not going to have as much control as you have with your toys and your characters. I assume that's also part of it, right? And Kevin Smith, he says this, I mean, yeah, but let's be honest, they're not knocking. So, they're not coming to the door right now. They're not actually offering a job, but he brings up the idea that Kevin Feige, he actually did get in contact with him before. Kevin Feige, he called me twice in my life and never once was like, come work for us. One was after a heart attack and they were like, call from Kevin Feige. And I was like, oh my God, man. You can see right there in the excitement too. He thought he was actually going to get a job. Now, I think this hit Kevin Smith right in the feels too. That's why he gets coy right here. You have the Uproxx directors saying, hey, that's like Make-A-Wish. And Kevin Smith, he says, yeah, that's what I said. I was like, I almost died, and now they're going to offer me a Marvel movie. I'm going to have to turn this guy down. But this is lovely. Yeah, right. Then apparently Kevin Feige called him yet again. And look at the way that this is brought up. Again, you can see what he's trying to ask without asking here. So he says, then he called me one other time to tell me about the Stan Lee cameo in Captain Marvel. Even then, that time, I was like, I think he's about to ask me to be in Captain Marvel and co-cameo with Stan. You can see the exuberance in that. And yeah, you know, Kevin Feige was like, nah, we're just looking for Stan's voice. So he got shot down yet again. Now this is where the begging comes in, by the way. I mean, read between the lines in this. I think everyone knows what my relationship with the Marvel movies is, particularly at Marvel. They're like, he's a fan. He will remain a fan as far as we're concerned. That's for the best, man. I don't have that kind of vision to pull that stuff off. Look, I'll be honest with you. This is where he's asking for it. Look, I'll be honest with you. This is the call that I really want. Kevin Feige calling me up and being like, will you be in one of these movies? That would be far more valuable to me than making one of those movies. Yeah, yeah, right. So he asked for a cameo in a movie. He's brought up being a director of those movies over and over again. But of course, he doesn't want that. Now, there's more in that interview, too. Oh, a lot. A lot more, in fact. But yeah, I think you get the picture. You have Kevin Smith, he's begging for a job. He wants his cameo. He know he wants to direct a movie. And after the mess with He-Man, like I said, I wouldn't be surprised to see this stuff pulled off. But anyway, you let me know what you think about this stuff. And as always, I appreciate the heck out of you. You make this stuff possible, so thank you. Want to help the channel out? There are links in the description. But you being here, that matters. So thank you. I appreciate you. I'm going to end here. I keep wanting to laugh at this stuff. But yeah, thank you. Appreciate you. See you soon.